Hello, I'm Natalia Singh and I'm currently working as a legal intern at Lexis & Company. Today in this video, I will be continue with the topic which I started in my last video, which is the landmark judgment of Joseph Shine versus Union of India. So in my previous video, I have discussed the facts of the cases, contentions which were raised and the issues. Now in my this video, I will be discussing the landmark judgment which was given. Before getting to the landmark judgment of Joseph Shine versus Union of India, I will be discussing few previous judgments which was given in relation with adultery. So in Yusuf Abdul Aziz versus State of Bombay, in this case the constitutionality of section 497 was challenged on the grounds that it violates article 14 and 15 by saying that a wife cannot be a culprit even as a abettor. The three-judge bench upheld the validity of the said provision as it is a special provision created for women and is saved by Article 15(3). And Article 14 is a general provision and has to be read with other articles, and sex is just classification, so by combining both, it is valid. Now let's jump on to the judgment which was given in Joseph Shine versus Union of India. So the Honorable Supreme Court gave its judgment in regard to issue 1, which was the classification is found to be arbitrary in the sense that it treats only the husband as an aggrieved person given the right to prosecute for the offense, and no such right is provided to the wife. The provision is not based on equality and it is violative to Article 14. The Honorable Supreme Court further added that the offence is based on the notion of women being a property of husband, and adultery is considered to be a theft of his property because it says consent by the husband. This provision does not treat the wife as an offender and punishes only the third party. The Supreme Court held that such classification is arbitrary and discriminatory and has no relevance in present times, where women have their own identity and stand equal to men in every aspect of life. This provision clearly violates Article 14. The judgment given in relation or in respect to issue 2 was, this provision discriminates between a married man and a married woman to her detriment on the ground of sex. Second, this provision is based on the stereotype that a man has control over his wife's sexuality and she is his property. It perpetuates the notion that women are passive and incapable of exercising their sexual freedom. The court held that the above provision violates the Article 15(1) of the Constitution because it is discriminatory on the basis of gender and perpetuating the stereotype of controlling a wife's sexual autonomy. Later, in respect to issue 3, the court held that the dignity of an individual and sexual privacy is protected by the Constitution under Article 21. The Honorable Court held that the enforcement of forced fidelity by curtailing sexual autonomy is an affront to the fundamental right to dignity and equality provided under Article 21. So the court came to the conclusion that the adultery is better left as a ground of divorce and not a crime. As Section 497 of IPC is struck down, and adultery can be grounds for any civil wrong, including dissolution of marriage. So thank you. That's it for this video, and I will see you in my next video. Till then, do subscribe to the channel for daily updates.